So we are going towards the unit second for data analytics. In the past lecture, we have came across about data analysis part, that is regular, and in which we understand the regression modeling and multivariate regression modeling. And in data analysis part, we understand what is machine learning. The today lecture is all about multivariate analysis. What really the today multivariate analysis is all about. See, data analytics is all about looking at the various factors to see how they impact certain situations and outcomes. When dealing with the data that contains more than two variables, you will use multivariate analysis. Multivariate analysis is not just one specific method. Rather, it encompasses a whole range of statistical techniques. These techniques allow us to gain a deeper understanding of our data in relation to specific business or real world scenarios. So if you are aspiring for data analyst or data scientist, multivariate analysis is an important concept to get a grip with, because it will this algorithm helps to get many variables for our consideration. Actually, this many variables is important to get the round of view of our concept actually. So in general, we need to understand what really the multivariate analysis is. In data analytics, we look at the different variable or factors and how they might impact certain situations or outcomes. For example, in marketing, you might look at how the variable money spent on advertising, but it impacts the variables number of sales. So types of environments will impact the number of sales. So the types of environments comes under the consideration of the multivariate analysis. In the healthcare sector, you might want to explore whether there is correlation between weekly hours of exercise and cholesterol level. This helps us to understand why certain outcome occurs, which in turn allow us to make informed predictions and decision for the future. There are three categories of analysis to aware of. That is univariate, single time, and two. When we analyze a single variable, when we analyze two variables, when we analyze more than two variables. So in the univariate analysis, we just look for the one variable. In the bivariate analysis, we look for the two variables. Multivariate analysis, which looks at some more than two variables. In a univariate analysis, we go for the single variable univariate, we go for the one variable. Bivariate, we go for the two variables. In the multivariate, we go for the three variables. As we see, multivariate analysis encompasses all statistical techniques that are used to analyze more than two variables at once. The aim is to find patterns and correlations between several variables simultaneously. Okay, allow us much deeper, more complex understanding of the given scenarios. Okay. So for the deeper analysis, we will increase the number of the variables. And here, when we increase the number of the variables, we will get a bivariate analysis. An example of multivariate analysis is, let's imagine we are interested in relationship with a person's social media habits and their self-esteem. So we can carry out a bivariate analysis comparing the following two variables. How many hours a day a person spends on the Instagram and their self-esteem score, measuring using the self-esteem scale. So when we draw that, we got this graph, hours of the spend on the Instagram per day versus self-esteem score of individual. Okay. So you may find that relationship between two variables. However, in reality, self-esteem is a complex concept. It is likely impacted by many factors, different factors, not just how a person spends on Instagram, you might also want to consider factors such as age, employment status, how often a person exercises, and relationship statuses, for example. In order to deduce the extent to which each of these variables correlates with self-esteem and with each other, you need to run multivariate analysis. So we know that multivariate analysis is used when you want to explore more than two variables at once. Now, let us consider some of the different techniques we might use to do this. Like, what techniques we can analyze, help us to analyze the multivariate analysis. So multivariate data analysis techniques and examples, there are many different techniques for the multivariate analysis. They can be divided into two categories, and they are dependence techniques and interdependence techniques. What is the difference between, let's take a look, multivariate analysis techniques, dependence versus interdependence. When we use the term dependence and interdependence, we are referring to the different type of relationship within the data. To get a brief explanation of the dependence method, let's move ahead. Dependence methods are used when one or more of the variables are dependent on others. Dependence look at the cause and effect. In other words, can the value of the two or more independent variable be used to explain, describe, or predict the value of the another dependent variable? To give a simple example, the dependent variable of weight might be independent variables such as height and age. Okay, height and age can decide what really the weight of the person is, like this. So height and age can be independent variable, and dependent variable is weight. So in machine learning world, so somehow you can relate this to regression analysis as well. So in the machine learning world, dependence techniques are used to build a predictive models. The analyst enters into input data into model, specifying which variable are independent and which one are dependent. In other words, which variable they want the model to predict and which variable they want the model to use to make those predictions. So it is like this. What are interdependence methods? Interdependence methods are used to understand the structured makeup and underlying patterns within a data set. In this case, no variables are dependent on others, so you are not looking for a causal relationship. Rather, interdependence methods seek to give meaning to the set of variables or group of them together in a meaningful ways. So one is about the effect of the certain variables on others, while the other is all about the structure of the data set. What that in mind, let's consider some useful multivariate analysis technique we will look at. What are they? They are multiple linear regressions, multiple logistic regressions, multivariate analysis for the variance, most important, factor analysis, cluster analysis. Let's have a look of different multivariate data analysis techniques. Before that, let's move and understand some internet thing. About multivariate analysis. Understand what are the things we have in the internet have regarding this technology. Let's explore something, because we need to explore the things. Actually, we need to explore the thing. Okay. So where the multivariate analysis is going to do our and help us define the research problem objective and multivariate techniques to be used. Develop multivariate analysis help us to define the develop the analysis plan, and we then evaluate and underline the multivariate techniques, estimate the multivariate model, and assess overall model fitness, interpret the model, and validate the multivariate model. So what really the multivariate model is, here the great learning we will understand what really the multivariate analysis is. So here in a blog we came across that multivariate means involving multiple dependent variables resulting in one outcomes. This explains the majority of the problem in the real world of multivariate. For example, we cannot predict the weather of any years based on the season. There are multiple factors like pollution, humidity,
precipitation, etc. Here we will introduce multivariate analysis, its history and application in different fields. The history of the multivariate analysis. In 1928, Richards has presented the paper, The Precise Distribution of Sample Covariance Matrix of the Multivariance Normal Population, which initiated the MVA. Okay. In 1930, R.F. Fisher, Hotling, and Nelson Roy and B.L. Zhu made a lot of fundamental theoretical work on the multivariate analysis. At the time, it was widely used in field of psychology, education, and biology. Okay. In the middle of the 1950s, with the appearance and expansion of computers, multivariate analysis began to play a big role in geological, meteorological, medical, and social sciences. From then on, no new theories and new methods were proposed and tested constantly by practice. And at the same time, more application fields were exploited. Okay. With the aids of the modern computers, we can apply the methodology of the multivariate analysis to data complex scatter analysis. Right now, we will understand the case with our imaginary example. Suppose a project has been assigned to you to predict the sales of a company. You cannot simply say that the X factor which will affect the sales. We know that there are multiple aspects of variables which will impact sales. To analyze the variables that will impact the sales majorly can only be found with the multivariate analysis. In most cases, it will not just one variable. Okay. To understand the cases, which will generally we not go for the one variable. So, like we know, sales will depend on the category of the product, production capacity, geographical location, marketing efforts, presence of the brand in the market, competitor analysis, cost of the product, multiple other variables. Sales is just one example. This study can be implemented in any section of the fields. Okay. Multivariate analysis is used for widely in many industries like healthcare. In recent event of the COVID-19, a team of data scientists predicted that Delhi would be more than 5 lakh COVID-19 patients by the end of the July 2020. This analysis was based on the multiple variables like government decisions, public behavior, population, occupation, public transport, healthcare service, and overall immunity of the community. As per the data analysis study, Murtuza Heather of Ryerson University on the cost of the apartment, what led to the increase in the cost or decrease in the cost? It also based on the multivariate analysis. And for the study, one of the major factors was transport infrastructure. People were thinking of buying a home location which provide better transport. And as per the analyzing team, this was one of the least thought of the variables at the start of the study. But with analysis, this came in the few final variables impacts the outcome. Okay. So this time in the practical problems, we use multivariate analysis. Multivariate analysis is a part of exploratory data analysis. Okay. Based on the MVA, we can visualize the deeper insight of multiple variables. There are 20 different methods to perform multivariate analysis, which methods best depend upon the type of data and the problem we are trying to solve. For an example, multivariate analysis is a statistical procedure for analysis of data involving more than one measurement or observations. It may also be seen solving problem where more than one dependent variable is analyzed simultaneously with other variables. So here we have input output and the process is defined. And what are the advantages and disadvantages of main advantage of the multivariate analysis is that since it's considered more than one factor of the independent variables and influence the variability of dependent variables, the conclusion draw is more accurate. Second advantage is the conclusion are more realistic and nearer to the near life situation. What are the disadvantages? The disadvantages of the multiple analysis includes the requires a rather complex computation to arrive at the satisfactory conclusions. Many observations for the large number of variables need to be collected and tabulated. It is rather time-consuming process. So, how we define a classification chart in the multivariate technique? Let's have a look. Selection of the appropriate multivariate technique depends upon. First of all, we decide the number of dependent variables. And when we have one or more, then we define a dependence technique. When dependence variable level of measurement is non-metric, then we'll go for the nominal data, ordinal data. Nominal data have a discriminant analysis, conjoint analysis, logistic and regression. Ordinal data by pairs and correction. When you have a metric, then we go for an interval or ratio. Correlation is, then we go for the correlation analysis, bivariate analysis, multiple regression, ANOVA and MANOVA, conjoint analysis or canonical analysis. If we haven't any dependent variables, then interdependence techniques will be there. That's like factor analysis, cluster analysis, multidimensional scaling, corresponding analysis. So factor analysis, cluster analysis, multidimensional scaling, corresponding analysis have a no set of variables, you can say that. We are talking about the group of the data. Here, when we define some set of variables and when the charts are prepared like that, when we have, then we define it in the metric and non-metric form. And then non-metric will be divided into a nominal and ordinal data. And when in the nominal data, we have a discriminant analysis, conjoint analysis, and logistic analysis. In the ordinal data, we have experimental collections. So it's like that. So into correlation analysis, bivariate and multiple regression, and ANOVA and MANOVA, conjoint analysis and canonical analysis. So this is the how the analysis has been divided. And this is a very important figure actually. Okay, let's understand this figure. Are the variables divided into independent and dependent classification? If it has, how many variables are treated as a dependent in the single analysis? How are the variables both dependent and independent measured? Multivariate analysis techniques can be classified into two broad categories. This classification depends upon the questions. Are the involved variables dependent on each other? Not. If the answer is yes, we have dependent methods. If the answer is no, we have interdependence methods. Dependence technique. Dependence techniques are the type of the multivariate analysis techniques that are used when one or more variables can be identified as dependent variables and the remaining variables can be identified as independent. So dependence techniques are multiple regression, conjoint analysis, multiple discriminant analysis, linear probability models, multivariate analysis of variance and covariance, canonical correlation analysis, structural equation modeling like this. So what is really in the dependence techniques, what really type is multiple regressions. Multiple regression analysis is extension of a simple linear regression. It is used when we want to predict the value of a variable based on what the value of two or more other variables. The variable we want to predict is called a dependent variable or sometimes outcome, target, or criteria variable. Multiple regression uses multiple x variable for the each independent variable x11, x21, x31, y1. Okay. And this is a classic example of linear regression as well. Then we have a conjoint analysis. Conjoint analysis is a survey-based statistical technique used in the market research that helps determine how people value different attributes, feature functions, benefits, just make up an individual product or service. The object of conjoint analysis is to determine the choices or decisions of the end users, which drives the policy, product, or services. So that is used in many fields like marketing, product management, operation, research, etc. It is used frequently in testing consumer responses to new products and acceptance of the advertisements and in service design. Conjoint analysis techniques may also be referred to as a multi-attribute compositional modeling, discrete choice modeling, or stated preference research, and is a part of the broader trade-off analysis tools for the systematic analysis of the decisions. There are multiple conjoint techniques. Few of them are CBC, choice-based conjoint, ACBC, adaptive CBC. Like here, in the health economics example, assuming you were diagnosed with the prostate cancer, which is this
two treatments would you prefer? Like doctor and the family support this treatment. Doctor and family do not favor this treatment. Caution treatment gives only 1 month or no long or longer to decide. Active treatment requires action within week. No cutting. Treatment does not require any surgery. Surgery is some risk and hospital time. Sex decreased compared to the before treatment. Same as before treatment. Urinary short-term issues. Urinary long-term issues. Bowel short-term, urgent-term, frequent bowel movement. Bowel no movement. Lifespan. Life might hit lifespan. Lifespan. Life 5 years fewer than expected. So like this, we can categorize the cases and the people can in the different variables and people are able to design for what is the closest to likings from the condition. We have also a multiple discriminant analysis, linear probability model, and a MANOVA model, canonical analysis, structure equation modeling, interdependence technique, and these are the dependence techniques. What is really the multiple dimensional discriminant analysis is the objective of the discriminant analysis to determine group membership of samples from group of predictors by finding linear combination of the variables which maximize the differences between the variables being studied to stabilize the model to short objective into their appropriate population with minimum error. Discriminant analysis derives an equation as a linear combination of the independent variables that will discriminate best between the groups in the dependent variable. This linear combination is known as the discriminant function. The weights assigned to each independent variables are correlated for the interrelationships among all the variables. The weight are referred to as discriminant coefficient. The discriminant equation is F is equal to F0, B1, X1, B2, X2. F is a latent variable formed by the linear combination of the dependent variables X1, X2, XP is the P dependent variable and P is the error term. And B0, B2, BP is the discriminant coefficient. Next is a linear probability model. Linear probability model is a regression model where the outcome variable is binary and one or more explanatory variables are used to predict the outcome. Explanatory variables can themselves be a binary or be continuous. But the classification involves a binary with dependent variable and independent variables includes non-metric one. It is better to apply linear probability models. Binary outcomes are everywhere. Whether a person died or not, broke a hip, has hypertension or diabetes. We typically want to understand the probability of the binary outcome as given explanatory variables. We could actually use our linear model to do so. It is very simple to understand why if y is an indicator of dummy variable, then EYX is the proportion of given X, which we interpret as the probability of Y given X. That is called, like, you know, here we derive a condition. That is equal to β0, β1, H plus ZI1. So we can interpret parameters of the change in the probability. Y when Y change by unit of, or for a small change in X. For example, if you model, we could interpret β1 as the change of the probability of the dead and gestational year of the age. Now, very important matter. What is the MANOVA, multivariate analysis of the variance? It's an extension of the common analysis of the variance. In ANOVA, difference among various group means on a single response variables are studied. In MANOVA, the number of response variables is increased to two or more. The hypothesis concerns a comparison of vectors of group means. MANOVA has a more factors, which each with two or more levels and two or more dependent variables. The calculations are extension of the general linear model approaches used for ANOVA. Canonical correlation analysis. Canonical correlation analysis is the study of the linear relationship between two sets of variables. It is multivariate extension of the correlation analysis. CCA is used for two typical purposes: data reduction, data interpretation. You could compute all the correlation between variables from one set P to the variables in the second set Q. However, interpretation is difficult when PQ is large. Canonical correlation allows us to summarize the relationship between the lesser number of the statistics while presuming the main factor of the relationship. In a way, the motivation for the canonical correlation is very similar to the principle of the component analysis. Next, let's move toward the structured equation modeling. The structured equation modeling is a multivariate statistical analysis technique that is used to analyze structure relationship. It is extremely broad and flexible framework for data analysis. Perhaps better thought of as a family of related methods rather than a single technique. SEM, which is single analysis, can assess the assumed causation among set of dependent and independent constructs. that is validation of the structure model and the loading of the observed items in their expected latent variables. Construct, that is validation of the measurement model. The combined analysis of the measurement and the structured model enables the measurement errors of the observed variable to analyze as the integral part of the model. The factor analysis combined in one operation with the hypothesis testing. Next, we discuss many techniques about the dependence techniques. Let's move towards the independence techniques. So interdependence techniques are a relationship that variables cannot be classified as a dependent or independent, you know, like cluster analysis, factor analysis, multidimensional scaling, and corresponding analysis. It aims to unravel the relationship between variables and subject without explicitly assuming the specific distribution for the variables. The idea is to describe the pattern in the data without making very strong assumption about the variables. Let's move understand this part as well. What is the factor analysis? Factor analysis is a way to condense the data in many variables, in just a few variables. For this reason, it is sometimes called dimension reduction. It makes the grouping of the variable with high correlation. Factor co-analysis includes techniques such as the principal component analysis, factor analysis. This type of techniques is used as a pre-processing step to transform the data before using other models. When the data has too many variables, the performance of the multivariate technique is not an optimum level, as patterns are more difficult to find. By using factor analysis, the pattern becomes less diluted and easier to analyze. Next is cluster analysis. Cluster analysis is a class of techniques that are used to classify objects or cases into relative groups or clusters. Cluster analysis, there is no prior information about groups or cluster membership for any of the objects. While doing cluster analysis, we first partition the set of data into groups based on the similarities and then assign labels to the group. The main advantage of the cluster over classification is that it is adaptable to change and helps single out useful features to distinguish different groups. Cluster analysis used in outlier detection applications such as detection of the credit card fraud. As a data mining function, the cluster analysis serves as a tool to gain insight into the distribution of data to observe the characteristics of each cluster. Next is multidimensional scaling. Multidimensional scaling is a technique that creates a map displaying the relative position of the several objects given only a table of distance between them. The map may consist of one or two or three or even more dimensions. The program calculated either the metric or the non-metric solution. The table of distance is known as the proximity matrix. It arises either directly from experiment or indirectly as the correlation matrix. Correspondence analysis. Correspondence analysis is a method for visualizing the rows and columns of a table of non-negative data as points in a map with specific spatial interpretations. Data are usually counted in a cross-tabulation, although the method has been extended to many other types of data using appropriate data transformation. For cross-tabulation, the method can be considered to explain the association between the rows and columns of the tables as measured by the Pearson chi-square statistic. The method has a similar similarity to principal component analysis in that it situates the rows or the columns in high dimensional space and finds a best fitting subspace, usually a plane in which approximate the points. The correspond table is a rectangular two-way array of non-negative quantities that indicates the strength of association between the row entry and the column entry of the table. The most common example of the correspondence table is a contingency table in which row and column entries refer to the categories of two categorical variables and the quantities in the cell of the tables of frequencies. Now we understand about the dependence method and interdependence method. What are the objective of the multivariate analysis? Let's understand. First and foremost objective is data reduction or structural simplification. That is, this helps data to get simplified in a possible without sacrificing available information. This makes interpretation easier. Second is sorting and grouping. When we have a multiple variable group of similar objects or variables are created based upon the measured characteristics, then it is the investigation of dependence among the variables. The nature of the relationship among the variables is of interest. Error, all the variables mutually dependent are on the more variable dependent on the others. Next is prediction relationship between variables must be determined for the purpose of predicting the values of one or more variables based on the observation on other variables. Hypothesis construction and testing. A specific statistics hypothesis formulated in terms of the parameters of multivariate populations are tested. This may be done to validate assumptions to
or to reinforce prior convictions. Model building process. Model building, choosing predictors is one of those skills in statistics that is difficult to tell. It is hard to lay out the steps because at each step you must evaluate the situation and make the decision next step. But here are some steps to keep in the mind. The primary stage, stage one, deals with the analysis of object, you know, and then concern and testing for the assumptions. The second half deals with the problems referring to the model estimation, interpretations, and model validation. Below is the general flowchart of the building and an appropriate model by using the application of the variable techniques. Like, first of all, we need to define the research problem, objective, and multivariate technique to be used. Then we move towards the develop analysis plan. Then we move towards the evaluate the assumption underlying the multivariate technique. Then we move towards estimate the multivariate model and assess overall model fit. Then we move towards the interpret the model. Then we move towards the validate the multivariate model. So what are the model assumption we have? Model assumption is the prediction of the relationship between the variables is not an easy task. Each model has its assumptions. The most important assumption underlying the multivariate analysis are normality, homocidacity, linearity, and absence of the correlated errors. If the data step does not follow the assumption, the researchers need to do some pre-processing. Missing the step can cause incorrect model that produces false and unreliable results. What are the multivariate statistics summary? Here those summaries are. The key of the multivariate statistics underlying conceptual relationship of one technique is regard to the kinds of the problem each technique is suited for, the objective of each technique, the data structure required for each technique, sampling consideration for each technique, and underlying the mathematical model or lack of thereof for each technique, potential for the complementary use of the technique. And finally, I like to conclude that each technique has a certain strength and the weakness that should be clearly understood by the analysts and before attempting to interpret the results of the technique. Current statistical package like SAS, SPSS, SPSS, others make it increasingly easy to run a procedure, but the results can be disastrously misinterpreted without adequate care. Okay, so multivariate analysis, we can say that if you're not able to understand simple methods, we're not able to understand the very, we haven't understand. So here in this, it's all about we have this thing we have covered, you know. So let's move in the next lecture. We will go towards the Bayesian model. Thank you for your patience.